State Minister for Sports Peter Ogwang has today visited Team Uganda in the Paralympics Village. He has been accompanied by the National Council Sports Chairman Ambrose Deshovia and the Council's General Secretary Dr. Patrick Ogwell. Minister Ogwang assured the athletes that they have equal allowances for the and stipend for the medals won, like the Olympics athletes in their bags.
Athletes, and that is the same price for Olympics, both para and mini Olympics. So, mine, what I have learned here is entirely an investment in sports. Number two, what I've learned here is that we need to put in a lot of investment also in the para sport, because to be honest, the equipment is quite expensive. For para sport, like I was told, the bicycles which we were using for competing, there are some of them which cost about $20,000. But also there are other equipment which I'm very sure we will be able to do better. But they have also appreciated government for the first time, the kind of facilitation they have got, the kind of support for their qualification they have got. It's quite big to them.
Gold goes for 1 million, 50 million for silver, and 30 million for bronze. Ogwang also echoed on the need for the development of para sports infrastructures in the country.
The challenge is we need to continue putting additional resources into para. And well, last but not least, we are coming back and I'm going to carry out a mobilization drive, because I'm very sure there are many para sportsmen and women who are out there at home, various parts of the country, who maybe would have been done better. But in terms of our messaging, in terms of encouraging parents to bring them up, do this work, maybe it has been low. I want to call upon our dear parents who have children with disabilities, that it's no longer a question of a child being disabled. It's a question that they can do what we can do.
Swimmer Husna Kukundakwe, who returns to the pool on Wednesday for the S8 50 meters freestyle, welcomed the development of putting the athletes in the same category for the stipend and facilitation.
That concept in general shows how Uganda is moving towards equality and inclusion for people with disabilities. Just knowing that the Olympics and Paralympics are now considered to be at the same level and acquiring the same opportunities is already an achievement and all that. And also because he spoke about being a professional athlete. Professional athlete without maybe any other side jobs can be quite expensive, paying for training fees, food, all that stuff. So with these parastatals and this monthly salary that comes with them, it's to support that training. Of course, with support, extra support from the government, especially when it comes to huge events like this, there is that training support, there's a training fund. But outside of that season, off season, that salary that they're getting from those from what are they called again? Those parastatals. Yeah. From those parastatals, they can be beneficial just even off season as much as they are on season, because they just support the livelihood of an athlete, which is something that is important. Most of these people are adults. Most of these athletes are adults. Me, I'm under the care of my mom. So even I can't get the parastatal now because I'm still a minor. But of course, when I turn 18, it's something that I'm going to vouch for, because it's something that's going to keep me going my day-to-day life like these other athletes.
Joni Sempija for Vision Sport.
Download the app on App Store or Google Play Store now. Vision Digital Experience, the future of media.